Let's talk about performance. I think that's one of the most exciting things for me with this helicopter because the performance is gonna be absolutely incredible. So what you can actually do is you can take five people that are 200 pounds or 95 kilos a piece. So it's five seats. You can fit all five with normal size males or good sized people. You can put 60 pounds or 27 kilos of luggage in the baggage compartment. The baggage compartment's huge and there's lots more capacity for that. If you're lightening up some of those passengers, and you can take 3 hours worth of fuel. So that's an incredible range for a big load of people. And then you can go all the way up to 10,000 feet on a plus 15 degree ISA day up there, and you can still hover out of ground effect and still come vertically climbing out of confined areas at around 300 feet per minute at 10,000 feet. It's incredible, the performance. I haven't flown any helicopters in this category that can come anywhere close to that. And so that's gonna be absolutely incredible for max takeoff and landing at the same conditions. So full gross weight load, plus 15 degree ISA day, you can actually take off and land all the way up at 14,000 feet. Just give me 30 seconds of your time. I wanna invite you to the Hill Helicopters exclusive presentation. This is a presentation that Ruben and I do online. It takes 30 minutes and we walk you through all the details, the specs, the performance of the helicopter, as well as the development stage that we're at. And at the end of the presentation, we give you an opportunity to pre-order the aircraft now under special conditions. If you want to book one, just go to hillhelicopters.com/schedule and I'll see you there. So we get people all the time saying, oh, I don't know, is the helicopter gonna have enough performance where I live? I'm Mexico City, 8,000 feet, high density altitude. I'm you know, in Chile or different places with high altitude airports, etc. There aren't very many places in the world with airports or landing areas that you're not gonna be able to go to with this helicopter, with even a full gross weight load. You lighten it up a little bit and it can even go higher than that. But I think, for me anyways, the performance is something I'm so looking forward to in all the different areas that I'm gonna be flying this aircraft in. In Canada, for sure, is one of the places, but so many places around the world that you're gonna be going to high elevations, wanna load it up, have a bunch of people, have a bunch of cargo and everything, and still be able to operate the helicopter at those high conditions, or in those really, really hot conditions as well for those high density altitudes. So, definitely something I'm excited about, and I can't wait to see stories from you guys when you're getting your HX50s of where you're taking the helicopter and what kind of things you're doing with it. Having that performance, having that extra power is something that you're going to be able to use for those fringe cases, those really high altitudes, etc. But it's also something where on the day-to-day operation is going to hugely improve your safety. And that's, I think, one of the big features, the safety features added to this aircraft, is the average person is going to be in here with 2, 3, 4 people, whatever happens to be. Maybe it's a husband and wife and a couple of kids or 3 kids in the back seat, whatever it is. A lot of the time you're not actually going to be all the way up at gross weight. And then you're going to be flying the aircraft typically in general at much lower altitudes, 3, 4, 5,000 feet. So there's a huge power reserve under those conditions. And that huge power reserve obviously gives you an extra buffer of safety. You can make mistakes in a helicopter if you have power to get out of it. You can fix those mistakes. And that's something that's really nice, because if you're a low time pilot that doesn't maybe fly very often, for example, those mistakes can be made. And you're still gonna be able to get yourself out of them, which I think is gonna be a really nice added feature. When you're always operating at the max limit of the aircraft, there's really no room for that type of error. So I'm looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to seeing pilots all around the world flying these aircrafts, having that margin of safety in there. I think that's gonna really improve the overall safety stats of the helicopter as well. So hope you enjoyed it, and we'll talk soon.